combination of our if and for instructions in small basic. Today we are going to learn this thing, how you will apply for if and for instruction in our coding. We will follow the same code as written on the book. Okay, first we will write text window dot write line, type C for square and T for triangle. We will start from here and end by, and after that we will put if and for to draw a square and triangle according to our choice. Okay, like we will put our readings, move and turn readings. So let's start how to make it. We need a small basic. I'm going to open. Okay, so here first we will write write command text window. You can choose instead of writing, and then next is your write line, and here we will put our data in quotations mark. Keep in mind this thing, don't forget the quotations mark. Type C, capital C for square. As I told you that we will take same code from book, we will finish that one, then we will put our for and next condition. So this is triangle. Okay, we have finished first line of our code, then we will jump on next line by press enter button. Here we will put our variable, next choice, because it's a user choice, our choice, and then text window. And then we will put read command. Sorry, here is not colon, it's the is equal to sign, that's why it's give the error. Okay, now there is no error. So our third line is while. We're gonna use while conditions. Let's put the conditions here. It's a choice. And then we will put the sign, and in quotations mark we will put capital C, and then and choice. Our second choice is a T. Same command we're gonna use, and in quotations mark we will write type. It's finished now. We jump on next line, text window. We're gonna choose instead of writing, and then we will write here our same write command, quotations mark of course, type, or you can simply copy paste. If you don't want to type again, you can simply copy and paste it here to save our time. Then we will write now read command for the computer. As we discussed, that is a dialogue between you and the computer, between user and computer. So now this for the computer, will read it. Then here we already put our end while condition, and now we will put our condition. The first one is if our choice. Wait, let me here we will put our condition if our choice is equal to, not plus sign, is equal to, we have error here, and we will see the error later on. We finished 7 lines, and let's check the error first, and we will complete the other one here. We missed actually right line. This is our error that I forget to put right line. Okay. Now we fix this one. We will jump again here to finish our if condition. So we will put now for as is here. So I is our variable is equal to what is equal to 1, 2, 4, because the square here has 4 sided. So we will put according to our choice. Our choice is for square and then triangle. Okay, so what the turtle will do here, the turtle will move. We will put move command, and then what is the distance in pixel is 100, and then we will put turn. In turn we will define the degree. So our turn command, we're gonna choose an angle is 90 degrees. We finished here one, and now we will put second condition and for, and then else our second and next condition is else. We will put for triangle now. So it's for our variable is I is equal to, then triangle has 3 sided, so we will define here 3, and then our turtle move to distance is again 100 pixel, and then we will define degree. So turtle turn is 120 degrees. And then we'll put end for and an F. We have finished our code. Now we will run to see the result. Okay. For square. Okay, type C for square or T for triangle. Let's type T. Keep in mind you have to type capital C because we mentioned your capital C, and press enter. Now you can see the turtle is drawing a square. Okay, if we put T, the turtle will draw a triangle. How? Let me show you. Let me run again. We will type T for triangle and then press enter. Now the turtle will draw a triangle. So we learn how to apply if and for function in loop. Let me open again. Here we have finished. We wrote a small basic program that helps with 2 values. Okay, number 1 is draw a square, number 2 is triangle. Okay, and we control the input. Okay, we wrote C, then it draw square. When we wrote T, then it draw triangle. And we use what? While loop with if and for instruction or if or for condition. Thank you. Okay, so here we go with the product RT, product and number, product number. Then we will put text window again. Text window. White line. Then quotation mark, we will put product number. Now we will define our all thing regarding our invoice. Then PID number, so its name now is equal to text window, then read command. Then again text window. Now we'll define here product unit price. It's text window dot right line inverted quotations mark. We will write product unit price. Then we will again product our now first product name, then product up text window treat. Then again text window, right line, now in quotations mark, product quantity. Okay, we define product name, product unit price, product quantity, then our product quantity for QDA. The system will read text window dot read command. Now here we will put our formula that we want to apply to calculate our products. Formula is total underscore price is equal to PRT underscore up steric PRT underscore quantity, and then TOT for total underscore INV for invoice is equal to, then TOT again total underscore INV invoice plus TOT total underscore price. So we have done our two formulas, and then we will put here gain variables J plus I, and then and while and here one last one is the text window to right line. Now here gonna put our total invoice in quotation mark total. Okay, here here. Total invoice, then semicolon, then plus TOT for total underscore INV for invoice, and then we will put and while again the variables I is equal to I plus +1 and end while now. Okay, here we have finished our code. Now we're gonna run it to check to see the result. So we will type first the number. You can put any number. Let's say it's invoice number 2. Okay, then type the number of product per invoice. Okay, how many products you want in this invoice? Let's say 3 products. Okay, so product name, let's say is pencil. We visit the stationery shop and we buy pencils. Okay, unit price is what? The one pencil price, let's say is 3. And then quantity, how many quantity we bought? Let's say 12. Okay. Now the second product, as we mentioned here, 3 products. So we have to mention 3 products name. So number 2, one we already mentioned here, pencils. Number 2, let's see, notebooks. Okay, unit price notebook, let's say 5. How many books we need? Let's say 2. Okay, now the third last our product, it's let's see, eraser. Product unit price is let's say 1, and then how many quantity we purchase? 3. Total invoice is invoice didn't give the total price. Type the number. Okay, let me back to check. What is the problem? The problem is in the formula, or where is the problem? Here is total price, product up. Now this one is right, total. This one is also correct. Total invoice plus. This one is also correct. Then it doesn't make sense if we will put total invoice. TOT, here, this is our mistake. It's INV, not E. Okay, so in this way, you have to check if the program is not working properly. You have to check your code. So let's start here, type the number. Okay, let's say number 3 invoice. Let's say this time 2. We will just write 2 product name. Again, it's let's say it's a bed sheet. Okay, unit price is let's say 42. Now here we will write let's say vest. Okay, unit price is let's say 30, and product let's say 1. So now the total invoice here. Okay. So this is our total that we paid for this invoice. I hope you understand this one. Thank you. So we use the nested loops here, and we did one by one. We took the codes from here. Okay. Number 1, we examine the part of the program on the right. Okay, we examine it, and then line 1 and 2 determine the number of bills in the variable invoice number. Okay, so we put this variable invoice number our, and then line 5 and 6 determine the number of the product on the bill in the variable product number. Okay, 5 and 6. And then on line 7, the counter J is initiated to 1 and should be incremented by 1 in the second loop between line 8 to 10. Okay, so we have put here product number, this variable, and after that we complete our loops. Okay, we put product number, product unit price, product quantity, we add, leave all in, plus the formula. Okay, and we run the program to check how it works. I hope you understand this whole program. Now practice on this nested loops. Thank you.